Hiya, Giuseppe. Sorry about the audio and all of this. It's going to sound a little bit rough, I'm afraid. I'm using the earpods, and it's impossible in this recorder that I'm using to mix the balance between the earpod microphone and the computer microphone. But I think we need both of them to illustrate. Anyway, bear with me. So the idea here is trying to explain how to use Audacity to create or to apply a click track to one of your what I'm calling first loops. So the one that I've picked here, I've got it on the clipboard. I've taken four bars out of each bump, so I'm just going to Control V to paste these in, and we'll just have a listen to this. Okay, so nice and simple for a start, I think. Okay, so what I'm suggesting is that I'm not quite sure what to do here. We might try two different methods, but for the first one, let's try applying a click track to these full four bars and see if we can get that right. Okay, so listening, this is kind of the black art. First thing to do is to because I have in my tracks menu, I've got sync lock tracks on. I've got that done. So the easiest way to be able to independently edit one track without disturbing any of the other tracks is to add a label file. So if we go to tracks, add new, sorry, a label track. Oh, there's the train. Add a label track. So if I now click below this label track and then go up to the generate menu and then select rhythm track. So rhythm track is going to give us, I'm not worried about all this other, well, it's four beats, beats per measure. So this is in 4/4, which is what beats bums in. Then the critical one here is the tempo, the beat, the BPM, beats per minute. So I think the idea first is to use the preview button. Just have a little bit of a listen to what it's suggesting. So at the moment it's 108.2. If we just preview. Quick stop. To me that's sounding a little bit fast. I think it's probably, knowing you and me, it's probably more like 90 BPM. Let's just have a listen to 90. I think that's probably closer. So this is a bit of trial and error that we're doing here. So we might just accept 90 beats per minute and start there. And we do that by clicking OK. So we've got far more click track than we need. I mean, it's 2.5 minutes for a 12-second sample. So we're gonna be wasting a lot of this stuff. But let's zoom in by using Control. Whoops. Sorry. Let's go back to the beginning of both tracks by using the skip to start. Now pressing Control 1, Control 1, Control 1 again. No, Control 3. So now we can see the entire sample on screen, and we can see each of the bar clicks here. So the first trick is either to make the click track start where the music track starts, or the other way around. This is kind of critical, this little step, because it's lining up the ducks. Okay, so what we might do is I think we might adjust the music track, the top track, to suit the click track. So this becomes our one. Now if we zoom in on the screen again, Control 1, Control 1, Control 1. Perhaps not so much as that. Control 3 again. So what we're trying to do here is we're trying to marry the beginning of the music track with the first beat of the second bar. And probably the easiest way I can think of doing this is to copy a little bit of silence from the first track. So let's say about this much. I'm just highlighting a section of track here and then pressing Control C. Now if I now move the cursor to the beginning of the music track and then press Control V, you'll notice that's moved the music track over to the right, but the click track is staying the same. There's a little bit of scrag here at the beginning. I think we can not worry about that for the moment. So then I need to move it, I need to advance it further forward. Control V again. Control V again. Now we're getting close now, but I think we want to advance it just a little bit past beat one. Okay, so we're a little bit past now. So the distance here we're looking to change is roughly this. So again, this is a little bit of black art kind of sighted in, so I'm just going to zoom in a bit more, Control 1, Control 1. And you can see here that I've probably highlighted too much there. So highlight there to there and press delete. And we press Control 3 just to see how this looks. So you can see already that we may not have selected the right BPM. Let's just have a look here, or rather have a listen. So let's click before the start of the music track and then just play it. Okay, so it's pretty close, just a bit fast in my estimation. Okay. So it appears now that we have 90 BPM is going to be too fast for this number. So again, this is the experimental start of the exercise. So I will now delete the click track. And I think probably the best practice is to go back, skip to the start of the file again. And highlight the cursor underneath the label track, go to generate again, rhythm track again, and instead of 90, what do we choose now? Should we try 85? Oh, here it is, optional rhythm track duration in minutes and seconds. So 160. Okay, so that's 100 and more. What's the translation here? It was 3 minutes, was it? So this is seconds, 160. Let's just change it to 10 seconds. Or 10? Let's say 20. And click OK. And then we do the same. Now we've got to just do the same laborious process again. So we want to highlight the music track. And we want to zoom in with Control 1. Control 1. Okay. Now we need to, we're looking, this is beat one of the second bar. We're wanting to reconcile it, make it equal to this beginning here. So we need to advance the music track a little bit further. So again, just highlight a little bit of silence. Control copy. Go to the start of the music track. Control V. Needs a bit more. Control V again. Okay. Now we want to click and go to Control 1 and zoom in and see how close we are. So this one's pretty tight. Got it pretty close. I would say if we delete that much, that should put us on the click. Control 3 to zoom back out again. Let's see this. So this looks warmer. Let's just give it a test. It's slow. Listen to that again. It's just a tiny bit slow, so this is where we are looking for some natural time here. Now, because we've recorded this on the looper, we should find that we have something consistent in here. It's just a matter of finding where it is. So I think we're just a tiny bit too slow. So again, delete the rhythm track, generate rhythm track. 85. Oh, what do you say, my friend? 87. Let's try 87. I think that's too much. Maybe 86. Just a little bit faster. Ooh. Now that's an interesting thing to see as well, is that it's positioned the clip track right where I had the insertion point. We won't go into that at the moment. I'll just repeat the process. So I'll just delete the audio track. Go back to the beginning. Click underneath the label track. Generate rhythm track. 86. That's the one we wanted. And click OK. All right. Again, let's go to near to the beginning of the music track. Control 1, Control 1, Control 1. And again, when this time we can just delete a little bit to bring it up to the start of beat 1 of the second bar. I'll just kill that. Looks about right. Control 3. Let's play it, see how it sounds. To my ear, that's right. Let's have another listen. And we'll include the reason for keeping those first four bars will become apparent now, is that it gives us a bit of a count in. So down the track, when we want to start timing the beginning of songs and things like that, we can have a count in. So from the top, including the quick counting. So I'm pretty happy with that. I think we've got ourselves a clip track. So to capture the entire four bars, I've trimmed this recording a little bit here, haven't I? So really, we want to... Probably, I think, the entire production in the end is going to capture the four beat count in, and we might just keep four beats per count out as well, I reckon. I can't think of why, but I've got a feeling that might help us when we're stitching together suddenly things down the track. So our complete product is from the end of the count out. That's four up. Oops, sorry. Doesn't include one, does it? So here's the count out, and we're just using the... I'm using my trackpad to highlight this whole area. And then from here, now we've highlighted this, I would be going edit, copy, and then I'd probably start a new project here, just a new workspace. New, file new, and then click in the space, control W, and this should be our entire click track. Let's just have a listen, including the music. And I think that's the way we do it, Giuseppe. I think it's as simple as that. To drive the point home. Now that we've got this established, I would think probably here we would label it. So we would say we would call this audio track. Perhaps rename it. Rename it to click and 86 BPM. So if we ever need to recreate this thing or we want to use this 86 BPM click track for anything else, then we can identify it, because otherwise we'd forget once we change to all sorts of other beat patterns. Okay. And probably mix, I would rename it. So this is Beach Bum First. Beach Bum First Loop, yeah. Okay, so now we've got and I probably would now save this project. And this is where, just ignore me while I go through my complicated laptop pantry here, but this is where I've got all that stuff stored. Might be a tick. Audio intro. Giuseppe. Recordings, and our recording from the 1st of October. And I might make a new folder in here, I think. New folder. And this one is called Beach Bum. Because all this stuff is just about this particular track. Beach Bum. And I'm going to call this one Beach Bum. Beach Bum First Loop. And then by association here, just set two. I can't remember whether we do this in Beach Bum or not. But if there's a second loop that you want to apply over the top, or there's a first and a second loop that you want to make, then we can record either the overdub file, or hopefully we can record the second loop that you're doing over the top. So it'll mean a slightly different way of using the looper than I think you do at the moment. But we could, next file could be called Beach Bum Second Loop. And as long as we set them both to the 86 BPM click track, then we should be able to muck around with them and play with them independently and double them and put chorus on and double track and, you know, all sorts of stuff like that. So that's probably enough of me talking, yeah? Hope it helps.